Happy Friday, everyone, and thank you for coming to my channel. This week's project starts as always with a deep clean. As you can see, it was super dirty, using the same product from Dixie Belle, the White Lightning. For this project, I wanted to use a darker green, and because palmetto is a beautiful color but was not that dark, I started to play with the colors, and I combined in here the palmetto with caviar. As you can see, instead of darkening the green, it was actually turning it into sort of gray, dark gray. Because the light was not good, I didn't realize. So the first hand I applied this new color that I created. But you will see later on that the next day, the second coat, I realized that this was not a dark gray but green, it was a dark gray. So I combined also another color into the final mix. I put some very vivid green, and you will see in the second hand, the second coat of paint, that the color will really reach to a very nice dark green. For the first hand of blending, we do not want to make it perfect. We just want to make sure that we are covering all the spots, all the areas, and that we are overlapping the colors on, as I told you also other times, maybe, I don't know, 10 centimeters overlap of the colors. The back of this dresser, of this vitrine, is not wood. It was a prefabricated board, because I wanted to blend some colors there and to integrate this beautiful decoupage paper into the colors, I applied initially two coats of slick stick. In here I'm using a small artist brush and with a little bit of clean water, and I'm cutting the margins of the decoupage paper so that I am taking a little bit away of the, let's say, thickness of the paper on the margins. If we cut it like this with water and the brush, the margins will get super thin. And with the clear coat, I'm gonna use it for sticking the decoupage paper. One coat, and then place the decoupage paper in the center, straight. Just small sections. I did not put the clear coat on all the surface, just on small areas, starting from up to down. And with the small tool that I also bought when I got this decoupage paper, which is an, a roller, I press firmly the decoupage paper into the furniture. And you will see, as I go down, you will see that I managed to make this without any wrinkle. I'm super happy about this. It was really maybe first trying luck, I don't know, I have no idea, but the point is that I really managed to stick it on the furniture just perfectly. When applying the paper, it is very important to go with the roller from the center to the sides, because you will see that the paper will have the tendency to get into one place, and then it will create the wrinkles. So it's important to go from the middle to the sides so that you will have this perfect finish. So do not start from up to down, start from up to left, up to the right with the small tool. And the most important, take your time. I think it took me roughly about over half an hour, about 45 minutes to stick this decoupage paper on the furniture. So do not rush, take your time, go into small sections. When you apply the paper on the glue in the first, let's say, 30 seconds, you still have time to take it away from the surface and re-glue it, so it will not immediately stick. So you still have a little bit of flexibility. That's why it's important to take your time and to make very small sections. And after about an hour, I came back with the same big brush I used to glue it. I came back with the same top coat and I applied one coat of protection on top of the decoupage paper. In here I got literally, I think, around 5, 6, 7 different colors, and I started to play with the similar colors from the margins of the decoupage paper, blending these colors together and trying to make it loose into the background. You will see a little bit later how it was looking after the first hand. I also came for the second hand at a point, and I think it turned out really nice and really no visible line to indicate that that is an actual paper, not a painting. It really turned out very nice. I'm cleaning the brush on a clean microfiber cloth from time to time, especially when I'm changing from, I don't know, red to blue. And I'm playing around the painting with different colors, trying to blend them. The first hand was a little bit, let's say, raw, and on the second hand of blending, you will see a little bit later that it really turned out super nice, really no visible line between the paper and the paint itself. Here are all the colors that I used: chocolate, Dixie Belle Blue, Red Barn, Aubergine, and Palmetto and Antebellum Blue. And you can see how it looks after the first hand of blending. I wanted to create I don't know, something more feminine. So because Dixie Belle have these beautiful transfers, the magnolia transfers, I decided to create a frame out of these transfers, playing with the magnolia that I cut small pieces, and I just placed them here and there just as I liked. I did not try to make something perfect. I actually wanted to create something not exactly uniform. You will see a little bit later how I'm placing flowers and how I try to see which one is better for where and so on. It was a little bit difficult to put these transfers because, as I said, that board is not wood, it's actually a prefabricated board. And the finish of it was not very smooth, so it was super difficult to apply. Besides, it was very thin and I could not put too much pressure on it. I was afraid that I would break it. It was super thin, that prefabricated board, so I had to play very careful. After I place each of the transfers, I come back with my finger and I'm pressing firmly, taking out all the air bubbles that may be underneath the transfer, and then with a low abrasive buffer, I come back and I take away all the halos around the transfers. After about 4 or 5 hours, I returned for the hand 2 of painting. As you can see, the green is already more vivid because I added 3 frog green. I will put in the description the quantities that I used, palmetto, caviar, and this vivid green. For applying wax, I'm going with all kind of brushes. This one is the one that I'm using for the detail, the moldings, to go in all the areas. And with the microfiber cloth, I'm cleaning the excess of the clear wax that I'm adding on the project. This is the black. I will go with it for the details, and then I'm gonna play, you will see, with all kind of gold and with the new cactus gilding wax from Dixie Belle. Super beautiful gilding waxes. I super love them. And with a small artist brush, fan shape of brush, I'm coming on the different places, especially corners and on the midnight sky, especially because it will be easier to be seen. I'm coming with the cactus gilding wax, and then the same model of brush but a different one. I will apply a little bit of gold. I'm taking away any excess of the gold, so just a little tiny amount of gilding wax in gold I want to apply. I'm creating a kind of patina, playing with these two gilding waxes. Very nice and very beautiful. And then, using my favorite tool, my finger, I'm applying the gilding wax on all the moldings, and I'm creating nice, rich gold lines for these very beautiful moldings. The same mix of cactus gilding wax and gold gilding wax on the principal, the main molding of the furniture. The same on the bases. I'm using the green, the cactus, and then for the flowers and all these small smaller details, I go with the gold. Again, this is really a personal preference, depending on how much, where, which colors. We have a big diversity of gilding waxes from Dixie Belle now. We can really play with them as we want and where we want. And because I received a lot of questions about how I'm doing this brush strokes free finish, I'm gonna show you here a little bit of the process. So first hand is very watery, as you can see. Even if I don't have a good coverage, I don't need that. I will come with the second and third coat for good coverage. And then you see, this is the second hand, and no, this is the third hand already, and I'm misting the surface quite well, but I'm just misting it. I do not pour water on it, so I'm trying to spray the water equally, and then just a little bit of paint on the brush. I'm coming back and I'm barely touching the furniture with the brush, trying to make to make this from one end to the other of the furniture without making any stop in the middle, and the finish is really super smooth. And in here I will show you how I'm removing the paint from the furniture, from the glass. I prefer this way rather than stay and spend a lot of time to tape the window. It's much easier. And here it is. It's ready, and I think it's really beautiful. I love the richness of this green. As I told you, I will leave in the description the quantities. It's a palmetto, caviar, and three frog green from Dixie Belle. And for the top and for the low part of this darker shade of color, that this is the Midnight Sky from Dixie Belle. And here it is, my beautiful mother with the daughter. It's so beautiful. And as you can see, I have no wrinkles on the decoupage paper. I'm super happy with how it turned out. I really hope you also like it. If you did, don't forget to subscribe my channel for other projects and give me a thumbs up. And comment if you have any questions. Don't forget, you can always ask me anything. I will always come back to you and I will reply your questions. Thank you very much for watching me this week as well. And next week I'm gonna bring you another beautiful project. So stay tuned. Thank you. Bye.